In this presentation, I attempt to show you some historical temperature data from around Australia and how it's been trending over time. But in the end, the Bureau of Meteorology blocked me. I'll show you what happened later. Just as a note, I'm not here to make a political statement or anything like that. I'm just here to show you the data. You can judge for yourself. All the data is sourced from the Australian Bureau of Meteorology's website, bom.gov.au, although it should be noted they no longer wish to be called the BOM, but instead simply the Bureau, which apparently they've spent more than $200,000 on. Yes, that is what our taxpayer money gets spent on. Anyway, in the search box at the top, type data and then click search. On the results page, the first result should be climate data online. Clicking on that, you'll come to this screen and then click on text search. Now, my goal in this video was to take a few samples from around Australia, but unfortunately, I could only get the data from two locations until the Bureau intervened. I first wanted somewhere nearby in South East Queensland that wasn't a big city. According to the European Commission's Joint Research Centre, cities are often 10 to 15 degrees Celsius hotter than their rural surroundings due to things such as industrial areas, lack of vegetation, and dark-coloured building materials. So of course, if we're looking at temperature trends over time, I think it would be wise to avoid these big cities as obviously over time, new construction takes place, which could add to this so-called heat island effect. Anyway, back on the text search screen, you need to click on the data drop-down menu and select temperature. Then you need to click on the monthly observations. You can use the daily data if you want to, but I tried it myself and there's so much data, it very quickly becomes unwieldy. But I found their monthly data is perfectly fine. In the next text box, type in Brisbane and hit Find. Click on Brisbane and then scroll down a bit and you'll see a list of Bureau stations. For example, if you click on Brisbane, you'll see that there is a graph below titled Data Available for the Selected Station. For this station, there's only data from the 2000s onwards, which isn't very useful to us. Plus, it's a big city. So basically, you just need to click through the other stations until you find one that has a lot of data. In this case, Amberley, a suburb of Ipswich, fits the bill, which has data starting from the early 1940s all the way up to the present day. According to Wikipedia, Amberley has a small population of around 250 people. It looks fairly rural, it has Australia's biggest Air Force base, and as we saw before, the Bureau of Meteorology has a weather observation station here. Back on the Bureau's website, scroll down a bit and then click on the Get Data button. This will show you a table with all the data, but as usual, I want to download it as a spreadsheet. So you need to click on All Years of Data, noting that all the files that I'll be using in this presentation are the ones that end in data12. Okay, so here's the Amberley data. Remembering these are the average maximum temperatures for each month, I'll be using this column, which is the average maximum temperature for the year. Here's a chart of that data showing the average maximums since the early 1940s. If we put a trend line in there, we can see that the average maximum temperatures are trending upwards. However, I thought this doesn't tell the full story. What about the average minimum temperatures? So back on the BOM website, sorry, the Bureau website under text search, we can change the type of data from mean maximum temperature to mean minimum temperature. We'll download that data as we did before, and then I'll plot it on a graph. If we add a trend line, we can see that it is definitely trending downwards, perhaps by not as much, but it's heading downwards on average. So if we put them on the same graph, we can see that since 1942 in Amberley, on average, the maximum temperatures are heading upwards, but the minimum temperatures are heading downwards. If we average the two, you can see a squiggly line that goes pretty much straight across the middle. I'm not suggesting anything, I'm just showing you the Bureau's data. For completeness, I'll add a trend line. You can see that perhaps there's a slight rise, but it certainly isn't dramatic. Make of it what you will. Back on the Bureau's website, you can also select the highest monthly temperature. If you download that, you'll get this table of data. For example, in 1942, we can see that the highest temperature that year was 42.9 degrees Celsius, which is like 109 degrees Fahrenheit. Hot temperatures are certainly not just a recent occurrence. For some reason, they didn't include the hottest temperature for 1941, I assume because they were missing data from the earlier months. But nevertheless, I'm going to put in the highest listed temperature of 42.4. It might not have been the actual highest that year, but it certainly was bloody hot. so I'm going to put it in there because I'm feeling a bit mischievous. But of course, one-off hot days don't really prove anything, so of course we should plot these to see if there's any discernible pattern. Here's the chart that shows the highest temperatures for each year since 1941. If we add a trend line, it's trending slightly upwards. If we download the lowest temperatures and plot them on a graph, we can see that they are trending downwards. That is, on average, they're getting colder as the years go past. If we put them both on the same graph and find the average, we can see that the average is right bang in the middle. Although the highest and lowest temperatures are becoming slightly more extreme, the average is neither trending upwards nor downwards. Make of it what you will. For the second location, I found somewhere which is well away from a city, the Cape Otway Lighthouse on the coastline of southern Victoria. Here's a chart showing the average temperatures over time. Although the minimum temperature seems to be trending upwards, the average maximum temperatures seem to be trending downwards, as is the average of the two. One might argue that data from the 1800s cannot be relied upon, but as I said, I'm just showing you the published data. As I said earlier, I was looking forward to analysing some more locations around Australia. However, when I went to do so, I got this error message. Your access is blocked due to the detection of a potential automated access request. The Bureau of Meteorology website does not support web scraping. If you are trying to access Bureau data through automated means, you should stop. I tried all those links, but I get the same error message. I've literally been blocked from the Bureau of Meteorology. So much for my taxes. I'm not trying to suggest anything here. I'm not accusing anybody of nefarious deeds. I think I just downloaded too much data in a short space of time, and now I'm blocked. I know it's easy enough to get around. They're just blocking my IP address, so I could just go to the public library or request an IP change from my provider, or even contact the Bureau and ask them to unblock me. But who knows how long that will take. Anyway, that brings us to a definitive close. It was a bit of a failure, but at least we learnt how to access the climate data from the Bureau's website, and I learnt that you can actually get blocked from accessing government data. Funny, huh?